I will show you the top 5 features in the latest update of Power BI, June 2019. Now, June is usually a big month for Power BI features, and they didn't disappoint this time either. The number one feature is going to make your life and the life of all your report users a whole lot easier. So if you like easy, stick around. If you want to catch up on all the recent Power BI updates, then at the end of this video, just click in the corner and access the complete update playlist. And if you're just getting started or keep getting stuck in Power BI, make sure to check out our complete step-by-step Power BI tutorial. I'm Avi Singh, Microsoft MVP and best-selling Power BI author. And if you want to become a Power BI pro, make sure to subscribe and click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. And let's start at number 5, the updated pane design. Now, if you bring up Power BI, it's going to look quite a bit different. So again, the dark theme is gone, and this one has a lighter theme, and everything has been, the approach here is to get similar to the Office ribbon. And that's a great idea, because a lot of users come to Power BI using Office, using Excel, so they would have that sense of continuity. Now, Power BI team isn't just gonna stop there, they're gonna continue to kind of make progress on this. Now, of course, if you look at Office, and if I were just to pop over to Excel, and I have quite an ugly chart there, but you realize that Excel is a few steps ahead of Power BI here. So here you can see we have a contextual menu. So if I have the axis selected, then I see that option. If I have these headings selected, then I see the format legend. And of course, if I have the chart title. So right, so we have contextual menus, and it has a search capability, which you may not even have seen, but it can be pretty useful. And what this lets me do is let's say I'm trying to search for something, change axis, and it shows me options like that. Now, if you're like me, then you probably have gotten lost in the myriads of options that Power BI offers. So something like that would help, and it's a really encouraging sign that Microsoft Power BI team is just kind of leveraging all the good work in the UI design that's already been done in Excel, and that's gonna be a big win for the end user, which is us, my friends. Let's move on to number 4, which is the ability to now add visual level filters for slicers. Now, this is something that was kind of sorely missed, and it felt kind of weird. So with every other visual, you had the opportunity or option to add filters specific to that visual, but this was missing for slicers. Now, of course, in the slicer, a common complaint is, you know, people don't want to see blank. Well, that you can get rid of quite easily by going over here and either changing to advanced filtering and removing blank, or just doing select all and then removing blank from here. But besides that, you can now, let's say, go in and I can go to my territories table and maybe bring in the group filter and add it here, and then filter the slicer to maybe only show Europe and North America. So that was number 4. Let's move on to number 3, the ability to connect to shared and certified data sets. Now, connecting to a single data set is not new. In fact, this has been in the system for quite a while, and this is one of the most powerful features in Power BI. This ability to publish a data set and then have that be used as a single source of truth for all of your reporting needs. You can create multiple Power BI reports and multiple Excel reports connected to that single data set. Now, if you want more information and something to show you step by step how the structure works, where you author, publish, and consume from a single data source, then do check out my Power BI tutorial, which covers this in quite a bit detail. So while that functionality isn't new, what is new is this new concept of shared and certified data sets. So now when you go to Power BI desktop and say get data, connect to Power BI data set, you might see some new icons there. And as you can see here, some of these reports can be labeled as promoted or certified. So in a large organizations, users may often have access to quite a lot of data sets. So of course, this designation can help them zero in into the more important ones. All right, well, we're warming up here. We're at number 2, conditional formatting updates. Now again, this is something that we have seen It is not a new feature. We have seen this in a prior release, but as promised, Power BI team has released more functionality around this, and they have also promised that they will continue to do so. Now, it all started, I think, with this data colors, and you could go into data colors, and instead of having this be hard-coded, you could specify, as you can see, I've specified a function or fx, and you do that by clicking on the ellipses over here. And if you click on this, this one is using a color scale, but there are other options available to me as well. You can see rules and field values there. So it kind of started here, but again, Power BI team is completely making this a functionality across a lot of other elements. So one thing we had seen in the last release was this action button. And here you can see that the action, the web URL, is a function. And I'll just show it to you really quick. And I just connected it to a Google search. But if Jordan Turner is selected, then it's going to open a URL which is dynamically fed using the selected customer. So if I were to select somebody else, Janet Minos, if I click on this, again, you know, so obviously you're not going to connect to Google. You're probably going to connect to one of your other systems, which opens that customer in maybe like a transaction system or something like that. But again, for this release, Power BI team has gone further, and now you can change background color. So in this case, background color is using an FX setting in here. If I can find it, there you go, background color. So you can see, and the other one is using data color as an FX setting. So if you look at data label, but again, that is the direction that Microsoft team is moving. We're giving you the ability to freely, you know, kind of customize things based on a function, which can be a lot of different things. It can be, again, color scales, rules, field values, and possibly other scenarios here. And field values, by the way, is where you control it with a measure, and that is an exciting option. So here you can see that, you know, all of these settings, if I select different things, they automatically change color. And so maybe not a very pretty example, but you see the power and strength of this. And yeah, so this holds a lot of promise. Are you almost ready for number one? Well, we'll take a quick pit stop. We have some honorary mentions. One is the new DAX comparison operator that gives you a little more flexibility, a little more control when controlling things against zero and blank values. So that's a new DAX comparison operator. And then we have the performance analyzer pane, which we saw in a previous update. And again, you can click in the corner to catch all of the monthly updates. And this has new sorting ability, allowing you to zero in on stuff that needs your attention. And next, for those who love using custom visuals, then you have the ability to pin to visualization pane so that you don't have to, every time you start a new report, you don't have to add them again and again. Your favorite custom visuals are always going to be available to you in your visualization pane. One more shout out to our tutorial. So if you're just getting started or keep getting stuck, that's the way, that's your ticket out. So go check it out. All right, so let's go and talk about our number one. Now, this is one of those simple features, but life-changing. This is the visual header, and kudos to Power BI team for listening to the Power BI team, Power BI community, and delivering on this. So this is something where once you start building reports and somewhat complicated reports, you often want to guide the user, and you want to provide them some help as they're using this report and to tell them that what it is they're looking at. So I'm just going to show you the feature and then show you how it is turned on. So here, if you notice that this visual has a special icon. Are you ready? Do you see the question mark? Let me hover on this and you'll see. So as I hover on this, now this is a custom text that I typed in and just guiding them that, hey, just letting them know that they do have the ability to select a customer name, which they may not have known, right? So I added that as kind of a visual header tooltip. And you can also connect this to a report page tooltip. Now, usually these are used now, again, this is an existing feature which we have covered in a prior monthly update. So go catch up on all the monthly updates if you have no idea what report page tooltip is about. But usually we use when hovering over charts and stuff. But you can use that with this visual header as well. And just for having fun, I used it for here. So as you can see in here, if I hover over this, I used a picture in there. And of course, you can build anything you want. In this case, it's a static image, but this can be a live image if you wanted to. So it gives you a lot of flexibility, and this is where it makes your life really easy, both as a report author and for all of your report users, because now you can kind of guide them and have this guided experience help always available to them when they're looking at the visual and looking at your reports. So that's our top five list, my friends, and it was certainly an exciting month. Again, you can check out the complete monthly update playlist by clicking in the corner. Until next time, power on, my friend. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.